what may have led up to this deadly fire in Council Bluffs. A broken marriage, a protection order, two pending trials. Investigators think that all may have prompted Mark Vanderwoody to set the fire and take his own life.
Oh, he's burning the garage down. He's burning the garage down.
New at 6, we are taking a closer look at Vanderwoody's troubled past. Good evening, I'm Brandi Peterson.
I'm Rob McCartney. In the past month, firefighters have been to the Vanderwoody's house so many times, house was actually under surveillance.
So when the first calls for help came into 911 Monday, first responders feared the worst.
But even they were surprised to find Mark Vanderwoody's body inside the charred wreckage. KETV News Watch 7's Hannah Pickett is live with our big story at 6. Hannah?
Lori Vanderwoody lived here with her three young children. Mark hadn't lived here in months ever since Lori took a protection order out against him. But investigators say that didn't stop Mark from coming back yesterday when his wife and kids were gone. Just after 3 p.m. Monday.
911, what's that? An emergency.
Call after call to 911.
Oh my God, their house is on fire. Okay. They're like at 40 Norwood. I don't know. Okay, he's burning it. He's burning it.
Neighbors frantically describing this.
Oh, he's burning the garage down. He's burning the garage down.
Fire crews rushed to the scene only to learn the fire was intentionally set.
We believe we found the accelerants that were used.
An investigator saying 43-year-old Mark Vanderwoody is likely to blame. Firefighters found him dead in the master bathroom.
All things point to him.
But Vanderwoody was never supposed to be at this home. He and his estranged wife, Lori, were in the process of divorce. Lori filed a protection order against Mark in September, detailing abuse and harassment. In several text messages, Lori said Mark used terms like gloves off, eye for an eye, and let the beatings begin. And described Mark's temper, saying, quote, he has broken, smashed things in front of my kids, and my two oldest are feeling uneasy around him. Lori filed a protection order after Mark allegedly tried to run her off the road in September. County prosecutors charged Mark with assault. 3 months later, Mark was arrested again for violating the protection order in Omaha. But Matt Wilbur says they were about to charge Mark with felony stalking.
Many different incidences that were being investigated, I think, including sugar in the gas tank, you know, hundreds of text messages, plugging up exhaust vents for the furnace on the house, you know, like to fill the house with carbon monoxide, opening up natural gas valves, at the house.
Now, I did speak with family members today. They tell me that this is tragic on many levels. They say they're just glad that they will not be hurt anymore. Now, as you can see behind me, the entire house is destroyed. Everything inside of it was ruined as well. Because of that, the Vanderwoody family has set up a fund at U.S. Bank. You can donate again under the Vanderwoody family. As for Mark Vanderwoody, investigators are awaiting final autopsy results to determine his official cause of death. Reporting live in Council Bluffs, Hannah Pickett, KETV News Watch 7.